Good evening, and welcome to the May 2016 College of Business Commencement. I am Associate Dean Mike Biesing. Good evening to our graduates, families and friends, faculty and administrators, distinguished guests, and all of you who are here to celebrate the achievements of the class of 2016. But first, I have a couple of important announcements. Please do not leave your seats to take pictures of your graduate. We have a professional photographer here for that purpose. If you and your graduate would like a picture with Dean Gowan, she will be available for pictures immediately after the ceremony. We have a large number of graduates to recognize this evening. We ask that you not leave until the ceremony has concluded in order to show the final graduate the same respect that we show the first graduate. The Star Spangled Banner this evening is sung by Mr. Kyle Yampiro.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
brave.
Please join me in thanking Kyle Yampiro for that wonderful rendition of the Star Spangled Banner. Last evening, Kyle was awarded his Doctor of Musical Arts degree at JMU. Congratulations, Kyle. Students, I would like to recognize those people who play a key role at James Madison University. Please hold your response until everyone has been introduced. Please stand as I call your name. First, I would like to recognize Dr. Mary Gowan, Dean of the College of Business. Also seated on the platform are the academic unit heads of the College of Business. Dr. Tim Lowers, Director, School of Accounting. Dr. Art Gowan, Head, Department of Computer Information Systems and Business Analytics. Dr. Ehsan Ahmed, Head, Department of Economics. Dr. Hui Sono, Head, Department of Finance and Business Law. Dr. Marion White, Director, International Business Program. Dr. Matt Rutherford, Professor, Department of Management, on behalf of Department Head, Dr. Paula Daly. Dr. Andy Wood, Head, Department of Marketing. Dr. Michael O'Fallon, Director, Hart School of Hospitality, Sport, and Recreation Management. Thank you. You may all be seated. To the left of the platform are two of our faculty who will read the names of each graduate here today. Dr. Diane Linding, Department of Computer Information Systems and Business Analytics. Dr. William Grant, Department of Economics. Thank you. Please be seated. Please also welcome the family of our student speaker, Daniel Roppert. Celebrating with Daniel today are his parents, Anton and Maria Anna Roppert, and his girlfriend, Sandra Rausch. Please be seated. I now call on Dean Gowan, who will deliver greetings.
Good afternoon, and welcome to a lovely afternoon in Bridgeforth Stadium. Regardless of the weather, we are here for a very special and very important occasion. On behalf of the College of Business and James Madison University, welcome. We are honored to have you, the family and friends of our graduates and other honored guests, with us as we celebrate the accomplishments of our students and thank you, our faculty and staff, for your role in making this day possible for our graduates. Sitting before us today is the next generation of leaders of businesses and organizations. We have graduates headed to Goldman Sachs on Wall Street, KPMG in Northern Virginia, Bacardi in London, graduate programs in law and finance and accounting and global studies. We have students who will be joining elite sales teams at Fortune 100 companies and students already engaged in entrepreneurial ventures. We have students who have been inducted to many of the College of Business Honor Societies, including Beta Gamma Sigma, the International Society Serving Business Programs accredited by the Association for the Advancement of Colleges and Schools of Business. We have students from our accounting program who are prepared to take their certified public accounting exam. We have students from finance who are preparing for the Chartered Financial Analyst exam, and students from our hospitality program who have already received their designation as certified specialist in wine through passing a challenging international test. You, our graduates today, are an impressive group. and you're joining an equally impressive group of alumni who represent the leadership of many Fortune 500 companies, who are successful serial entrepreneurs, heads of professional sports associations, and leaders in their communities. Most of all, our alumni, as will you, remember to reach back and open doors for those who come after them at JMU. Now, it is my privilege to introduce to you one of those outstanding students, our student speaker, Daniel Roper. Daniel is graduating magna cum laude with a BBA in Management and Computer Information Systems and has quite a cheering crowd, I see. Yesterday, Daniel was honored as the outstanding graduate in both of his majors, Management and Computer Information Systems, with a friendly fight between the two department chairs about which came first. Daniel's an international student from Velden, Germany, a varsity soccer player, and a member of Beta Gamma Sigma Honor Society. After graduation, Daniel will begin his career with Deloitte as a cyber risk consultant in their Los Angeles office. Excuse me just a moment while we make sure his speech is ready. Okay. All right. Thank you, Daniel. Please share some words with us.
Thank you, Dean Gowan. Thanks to the CIS team over there. Fellow graduates, join me in welcoming Dean Gowan and the associate deans, the board of advisors, faculty and staff, family and friends. It is such a great honor to be here today and have the opportunity to speak on behalf of the James Madison University College of Business class of 2016. Everyone graduating this evening has taken a unique path to where they are today. I'm sure each path has had its ups and downs, with countless learning opportunities along the way. With this in mind, I would like to tell you my story on what has led to me standing here before you today. My story is about overcoming obstacles and finding a path to success. When I was young, I had one big dream, and that was becoming a professional soccer player. I didn't care about school, and certainly wasn't thinking about college, so I just got by every year. As high school became more challenging, the number of D's started to pile up. In 2008, towards the end of my preseason, the doctor diagnosed a stress fracture in my spine, an injury that made me question if I would ever be able to play again. I thought my dream had shattered into a million pieces. The result was that I barely showed up for school and my grades got even worse. It took me 8 months of physical therapy and self-reflection to recover. But I needed a new dream, and finishing school with good grades was crucial to pursue a different dream. I decided to repeat the 12th grade in order to have choices once I graduate from high school. At that time, I was convinced my path would lead me to work with athletes, not with business people. English was also not my forte at that time, so you can see I've come a long way. I became a more dedicated student, developing a growing interest in business and technology, and realized I could replace those D's with A's. Luckily, I was able to play soccer again. But I allowed myself to think that I could be more than just an athlete. I studied 1 year in Germany, excuse me, and once again, I looked for a new path, and that path brought me here to JMU, where I found my place to succeed. Being the first in my family to attend college, the only way was for to pay for my education was with an athletic scholarship. I'm very grateful that my early focus in life on athletics provided me another opportunity to come to JMU, where my early dreams and later realizations came together. And I used my athletic abilities to open the door to academic success. I'm very thankful for my coaches, Tom Foley and Tom Martin, for opening that door to me. My experience at JMU attending one of the top business schools in America and playing at the highest level of collegiate soccer has taught me many invaluable lessons for life. It amazed me how many leadership and team principles you can transfer to projects at school and work. I remember well trying to figure out all the time conflicts between classes and soccer commitments, the hours spent on the bus traveling for games, and the planning it took to find time to get my schoolwork done. I will never forget the wins and losses celebrated and mourned by that multicultural group of guys who became my brothers. Like me, all of you have a story and a path that brought you here to JMU. For each of us, James Madison offered a place to succeed, a place where we could follow our path and achieve our dreams, a place that provided both challenge and opportunity, a place that now feels like home. The past 4 years have flown by quickly, but we will always have shared memories about our COB 300 experience, an interesting or challenging class or professor, our ridiculous need for caffeine, and of course, all the networking events on Thursday nights. We learned about the JMU culture of friendliness, holding doors, and our motto, work hard, play hard. Gen Ed courses broaden our horizons, and our COB majors gave us the subject matter expertise we need. We learned to collaborate, to socialize, and to work hard. We learned to build relationships with professors, employers, and other students. We learned to solve problems and overcome obstacles. And all of our failures and successes have contributed to who we are today. So what happens now? This is a question most of us have asked ourselves a million times by now. We have to leave this safe harbor, this place that has allowed us to succeed, to explore the real world and pursue yet another new path to further happiness and success. This transition can leave us feeling scared and overwhelmed by all the endless opportunities and uncertainty of our new path. I believe JMU has prepared us well to succeed on our journey to a meaningful life by educating us to be enlightened citizens. As JMU grads, we have an innate competitive advantage. During our time in the College of Business, we have developed and owned our skills, our interpersonal and team skills, our communication skills, our quantitative and technology skills. We have learned to work hard and identify and seize opportunities that will allow us to succeed in the world of business. We all have many people to thank for that have helped us along the way to the path, on our path to success. We would have not succeeded without the deans, faculty, staff, our families, or the people who supported us here at JMU, our coaches or teachers that pushed us, or the friendliest worker at D-Hole. For myself, I have to thank my family. They came all the way from Germany to see me graduate tonight. I'm really sorry that I picked a country on the other side of the Atlantic, but I hope you're proud of me and I love you. Tonight, I wanted to share my story with you to show you that whenever in life one door closes, multiple new ones will open, including ones that you don't expect, and some you can't even imagine. Life has its ups and downs, but trust that they will balance out. In my case, what I thought was my ultimate dream became instead the way for me to achieve the success I've had here at JMU. Thank you very much, everyone. Enjoy tonight. Best of luck in the future, and go Dukes!
Okay, you're fine. You're fine. It was just, no, you're fine. It was it's just gonna have to hold it above my head.
Daniel, thank you for that awe-inspiring story, and thank you for choosing JMU and the College of Business for your education. We'll be following your career path. It is my privilege now to introduce our faculty speaker, Dr. Bill Ferranda. Sounds like a few students know him. Professor Ferranda teaches marketing in the College of Business. He holds BS and MBA degrees from Miami University, received his PhD from Arizona State University in marketing, and has taught at various universities, including the University of Virginia. During this past fall semester, Professor Ferranda served as the faculty member in residence for the JMU Study Abroad program in Florence, Italy. In that role, he ate a lot of really good pasta. I know, I was there for the first week of the program. He also taught a marketing course and helped craft a unique learning experience for students from majors across the JMU campus that broadened their worldview. His international teaching experiences also include teaching at a university in Germany. We seem to have a German theme tonight. That experience has resulted in research and other collaborations, including hosting two visiting masters in marketing students from that program this spring semester. Professor Ferranda was asked to be the speaker today in his role as the recipient of the Otto Brenner Outstanding Teaching Award for 2014-2015, an honor bestowed through his selection by the students in the College of Business. We asked a few of Dr. Ferranda's students to describe him as a teacher, and here's what we learned. Student number one, Dr. Ferranda genuinely cares about his students' success, not only in the classroom, but in life. He makes a point to get to know each of his students individually and constantly pushes us to our full potential. Dr. Ferranda dedicates himself to his job and making sure his students are understanding of the curriculum and able to apply his teachings to real-world situations. Student number two, I've always enjoyed taking his classes because of how knowledgeable and passionate he is about the subject. He is always able to keep the class interested and engaged. And anyone who's ever taught a class knows how important keeping students interested and engaged is and how hard that is to do. Last, I'd be remiss if I failed to mention Dr. Ferranda's keen sense of humor and his genuine compassion for others, characteristics that likely helped him keep the class engaging and interesting. So, please join me in welcoming our Otto Brenner Outstanding Teaching Award recipient, Dr. Bill Ferranda, to the podium.
Thank you, Dean Gowan, for those very, very kind words. I have had an unbelievable year, and it's largely due to my role here at James Madison University. And today is really the culmination of that. But first, I'd like to compliment Daniel for his remarks. I don't believe there's a more challenging role in this commencement exercise than to speak as a representative of your class. So, Daniel, vielen Dank für deine netten Worte, viel Glück für deine Zukunft. Ich möchte auch Daniels Familie begrüßen. Sie müssen sehr stolz auf ihn sein. So just as Dean Gowan alluded to, when you're part of the JMU College of Business, you have to always be ready to go international. Okay, for the next few minutes, I promise to speak in English. Just as Daniel's task was to speak on behalf of his fellow graduates, I'd like to say a few words to the class of 2016 as a proud member of the College of Business faculty. But I should warn you, if you're expecting invaluable insights into the three key challenges occurring in the globalized business environment today, or how the internet will specifically affect your chosen profession over the next 20 years, or how to follow the straightest path to success, you might have the wrong person. My path to this point, standing in front of all of you wonderful people on this memorable day, has been anything but straight. If you want to talk to someone who often zigged when he should have zagged, then I'm your guy. But even with that, I truly believe I'm in the place I was meant to be. Because each and every one of you will have those moments when you realize that a mistake has been made, an opportunity passed up. You cannot live a full life without this being so. Despite the inevitable disappointments and hiccups, the point is to put them aside as best you can, learn from them, adjust your plan, move forward while keeping a few things in mind. So today I'd like to speak to you about things that to me do not change, things that might help you avoid some of those detours. And they have more to do with what we call the softer side of the equation. 1 year ago, during the same ceremony, I was moved by the lesson my colleague Bob Richardson spoke of. Yeah. That of finding several mentors to provide the guidance we all need as we move through our lives and careers. So I ask of you some related questions. How will you navigate the workplace? How will you become the kind of individual others leap to work with, to support, to take direction from when that day comes? Certainly the skills you develop and apply, your ability to get the job done, will contribute mightily. But I believe a good measure will come from the way you interact with others with whom you work, and with the way you present yourself every day when things go well, and more importantly, not so well. A story from my first month out of school tells it best. While I proudly serve as a marketing professor here at JMU, my undergraduate degree is in accounting. I love the challenge of that major, but found work in the public accounting arena not so much to my liking. I say this with all respect to my talented colleagues in marketing, and to those of you who are about to embark on careers in that field, let nothing I say deter you. It is a great profession, and had I been more suited to it, perhaps today I'd be a hotshot partner at one of the big four firms. But I think that the world of public accounting breathed a collective sigh of relief when I made the decision to leave after 2 years and return to school to pursue my MBA and beyond, all in marketing. I mention this so I can relate to you one of the most important lessons I learned early in my 2 years of public accounting, and that's of humility. After being assigned to a small nonprofit client for a couple weeks, I was sent to one of the firm's biggest clients, a Fortune 100 manufacturing firm that had deep roots in Cleveland, my hometown. Our firm spent so much time at this corporation's headquarters that we had our own offices there. I was told to report to the supervisor of the audit team, a fellow named John Herta. After getting the nickel tour of the headquarters building and then returning back to our offices there, John said, "Oh yeah, it's your turn to clean the coffee maker." Whereupon I said, "I don't think so." John gave me a smirk that I would see so much of over the next few months and replied, "Oh, I think so." So I grabbed the coffee pot, went to the kitchenette and proceeded to scrub, all the while muttering to myself, "Who does this guy think he is? I just graduated from the best accounting program in Ohio. I just took all four parts of the CPA exam and I already own 5 suits. After I finished cleaning it, I filled the pot with water, managed to measure out the right amount of coffee and hit the switch, and pretty much steamed about this the rest of the day. Well, over the first week of the audit, guess what I found out? It was my turn to clean the coffee maker. Everyone from the newest person to the manager of the audit, I think partners were exempted, they're always exempted, took his or her turn cleaning the pot and making coffee. It was just one of those things the audit team had decided to do long before I was ever part of it. I don't think I was John's favorite staffer that year and that busy season, but when the next one rolled around, things were much better between us. I'd like to think that getting off my high horse, realizing I had a lot to learn, and concentrating on my job helped. During that second year when I decided to enter grad school, it came time to give my 2 weeks notice. Everyone with whom I had worked said nice things to me and expressed good wishes, but then I received a phone call from John Herta. He also wished me good luck, but then said something that has never left me. He told me how sorry he was that I was leaving, and that he thought I had what it took to go all the way in the firm. I could tell he was sincere, and I was floored. We had a great conversation, and what he told me that day, whether it ever could have come to pass, remains one of the most meaningful gestures I've ever received from anyone since I finished my undergraduate days. It told me that with John's tough help, and he was a tough guy and a heck of a CPA, I had indeed learned something valuable, something I have tried to exemplify ever since. I firmly believe you graduate today with the skills needed to get off to a good start, to make immediate contributions to the organizations who are competing for your talents. But the impact you make is not confined to the employment of those skills. It is magnified and made more effective by something as simple as humility, the realization that you have so much to learn from those who were there before you arrived. So if on day one, you are told it's your turn to wipe down the espresso machine and get the next batch of steamed milk ready for mid-morning lattes, you should just smile and say, sure, where's the sponge? Some of you may be familiar with James Carville, the lead strategist for Bill Clinton's 1992 presidential campaign. He invented the most famous phrase of that election, it's the economy, stupid. Carville is a raging Cajun, not always known for eloquence, but rather his tough talk. On the eve of the election, when victory seemed imminent, Carville gave a heartfelt talk to the workers at the campaign's Little Rock headquarters. What he said speaks very much to me, and I'd like to share the gist of it with you. He said that the two most precious things you can give are your love and your labor. Carville was so proud of this moment because these campaign workers had spent the past year of their lives combining these two gifts into one endeavor. He simply called that a merger. But I think he meant so much more. For many years to come, most of your waking moments will be about sharing these two precious gifts. And like those campaign workers, I wish for you that magical and fulfilling combination of your love with your labor. I'd like to think that many of my colleagues see this in their careers. I know I do. It won't happen every day. Weeks may pass. But if you can achieve some measure of this, then there will be moments when the love and labor you give will be indistinguishable. You won't be able to separate the two. Every year, commencement brings me mixed emotions. I'll admit that once the weather starts to warm, I'm a bit guilty of counting down the days to this week when exams are done, grades are calculated, and I can start to brush the rust off my short game. But I cannot help also to feel sadness and a sense of loss. Just when I am getting to know so many of you so well, it's time for you to leave and begin the next important phase of your lives. And on those days, during the first few weeks of summer, when I come into Shoker, it takes some time to get used to the quiet. And in the fall, when classes begin again, and I walk through the lobby and no one calls out my name to say a cheerful hello or ask me a question about a class or an assignment, I feel like a freshman from Idaho. So know that you will be missed, that your time here has made an impact on those who have had the privilege of being your teachers. And yes, once the new school year gets underway, that freshman feeling will fade. But for me, the next class does not replace the previous one. Each group of graduates makes its mark, adds to the legacy, contributes to what we are trying to build here in the College of Business. As I told you earlier, I'm not likely the best person on the stage today to give you advice for achieving career success. Thank goodness you have alumni role models like Jennifer Morgan to look to. But perhaps these little things I've shared with you, these personal things, will help you along the way, particularly over the next few years. Above all, be patient with yourself. You will make missteps and decisions you wish you could take back. It's a long road, and it's full of surprises. And times, things you can't control. But enough will be in your control to get where you want to go. Even in your times of greatest uncertainty, a good choice here, and perhaps a bit of a break there, combined with experience and perseverance, will likely lead you back to the path that is right for you. And here is my final wish for you, that you leave today with love for this institution. And more importantly, that it grows over the years, as my love has grown from my alma mater. because that will mean that you have put aside some of the more difficult moments, that your memories of the best parts of your time here remain, and that you will come to appreciate more and more what your years at JMU helped make possible. And when a few decades have passed, and you stand with your loved ones and survey all that is important in your life, you can say something as simple and as meaningful as, "Not bad, not bad at all." Thank you for the chance to speak with you today. It has been my honor to be your teacher, and I will miss you. And I will miss those of you whom I don't even know. So revel in this day, in this weekend. Celebrate these years of hard work and accomplishment. Let us know how you are. Come back to your JMU home in this beautiful part of Virginia whenever you can. And best wishes always. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Ferranda, for those words of wisdom and encouragement for our students. Now it is my privilege to introduce our alumni speaker, who is a role model that all of you should aspire to be like. Jennifer Morgan was appointed president of SAP North America in May 2014. In that role, she is responsible for leading the business in the North America region with more than 109,000 customers in 25 industries across the US and Canada. She is leading the company's rapid journey and growth in cloud computing and digital innovation. Jennifer has re-energized the company's workforce in the US and Canada and engaged the nearly 20,000 employees in new and innovative ways, placing a priority on building a culture where every employee is an innovator and every customer is disrupting, thriving, and growing in the digital era. Prior to being named president, Jennifer served in a number of leadership roles for SAP, including leading SAP's public sector business and other regulated industries. She was a recognized thought leader on government and public sector technology innovation, represented SAP to the US government, and testified before the US Congress on many issues. Jennifer serves on a number of nonprofit and academic boards, including the National Academy Foundation and Gen Youth. She's a 1993 graduate of JMU who majored in finance, and she currently serves on the board of advisors for the college. I am pleased to welcome Jen Morgan to the podium just as the showers start coming down hard. So,
thank you, Mary. Thank you, Mary.
Thank you very much. Mary, I appreciate the kind introduction. And this chance to be with you, I won't waste time in saying what everyone in the class and audience is feeling, and of course your families. Class of 2016, well done and congratulations. As you heard in Dean Gowan's introduction, I went to JMU. Not so long ago, I sat exactly where you are, whispering to friends the same question that's now on your minds. How long is she gonna talk? It helps to have a little situational awareness. And the answer to that is, as your very first graduation present, a special treat, I'm here with a short speech. Straightforward and without airs is the way we learn to do things here at JMU and the Berg. And when you've been away, you appreciate that spirit even more. It's a down-to-earth kind of school where you don't hear lots of big talk. You just see people getting the job done. And whenever I describe this place to friends, I always mention the railroad tracks that run through the heart of campus. We don't think much about where they begin or where they end. All we know is the little stretch of the path. If you're looking for a simple image to capture the JMU experience, it's not a bad one. It's a time in our lives set apart from what came before and what comes after. The experience seems to change us decidedly for the better, and I'm not sure every college can say that. Year after year, our alumni are proving that a JMU degree can take you far. It has meant everything to me in my career, and in the company where I am at SAP, I'm honored to lead 20,000 employees across the US and Canada at SAP. It stands for Systems, Applications, and Products, combining three words that seem to cry out for explanation. And even if I stop to elaborate on each one, your parents and grandparents might say after the ceremony, what does that lady's company make again? Well, we make software, enough to rank as the fastest growing cloud computing company and world leader in enterprise applications. And I was trying to think about how I could give you a sense for our global reach. I could tell you how our software touches $16 trillion of consumer purchases in the world, or how our customers represent 98% of the world's most valued brands. And then I remember two other stats that the JMU in me finds very powerful. Our customers, using our technology, produce 82% of the world's coffee and 77% of the world's beer. Pretty impressive. Software is involved in just about every process and industry, and so are we. And that's the way things are these days. Products and services of companies can't be put into narrow categories. But it does tell you something useful and pretty impressive. SAP has operated for 43 years in a broad field where 5 years in business can make a company appear established. A decade can make a company seem old. And anything past that can make a company vulnerable. And for 4 decades, we've navigated our way from mainframe and database computing to cloud computing and all that goes with it. And that's a world of change in a stretch of time when an awful lot of tech companies have come and gone. I know that everything has gone to a new level when people started using the term disruptive to describe something good. Now everybody wants their plans and their next move to be disruptive. But of course, not everyone will come up with that kind of idea. But all that is certain is that disruptions will keep coming and they'll change the way you work and live everywhere. So I'll spare you the standard futuristic vision of transformations yet to come in business, the digital talk that every tech leader can give. More practical, I hope, are a few simple ideas for use in any career at any time. They're not about the big trends. They're about little things that can make a big difference. They're not generational themes, just advice for every day. And by the way, I don't hold it all out for wisdom of the agents. I put it more in the category of obvious, yet often underlooked and easily forgotten. The first is to let preparation define everything you do. I can recall learning this the hard way. A few years ago, I was called in by my CEO to give a business review. I was in a new role, and everything was awesome. The numbers were great, we had a rocking quarter, and I had an answer to every question. At least I thought I did. And after I finished covering our fantastic quarter, the CEO said, "That's really great. Now just tell me one thing. Where are you taking this business next? What's your strategy?" And what followed by me was a jumble of visionary sounding words made up on the spot. I'd come in ready for every question except the main one, and not for lack of effort. I was so pleased with today, but the CEO wanted to talk about tomorrow. What the CEO saw was complacency. Sometimes you're not truly prepared until you've looked at a matter from every angle, especially a wide angle. All your points about the present have to add up to a point of view about the future. That takes extra work, and it can sometimes take something harder than work. Calm, clear thought to really understand where you're going. It's all part of the discipline of preparation. Never mind what else changes in the tech world or any other kind of business, preparation never goes out of style. Second, when you look behind the curtain in most organizations, you gradually come to realize that the people at the top don't necessarily know that much more than everyone else who works there. We tend to assume, especially when we're young, that there's some special knowledge for which we don't have the password, the secret playbook that somebody will give you when the time is right. There's various drawbacks to that assumption, starting with the fact that it's usually not the case. And sometimes it can hold you back. I remember when a senior colleague at SAP first asked me when I would be ready for the next move, the next big job. And I told him, "I think I probably need another year to get ready." My thinking was that there must be more leading to managing a large, complex business than I could have possibly figured out. I was waiting for some revelation that never really comes. I was buying time when a great opportunity was right there in front of me. When others think you're ready, there's a good chance you are. So my advice is don't worry about the secret playbook. Take the leap. Third, there's no secret master plan to making choices between professional ambitions and the rest of life. Or if there is one, nobody shared it with me yet or anyone else I know. There's all kinds of books, philosophies about the work-life balance, especially for women. And even the people with the most advice will tell you that even their approach isn't the right fit for everyone. But for me, I've learned the least to take these choices very seriously because they have consequences we have to look at realistically. And balancing work and life needs the same constant and careful attention, whether you're a mother or a father. If you want to be with your 7-year-old child, you can't do it when he's 15. There's no banking time for another day. Managing time before it's gone can get complicated and tough. It can be a real fight. My only advice, make sure what you're fighting for is what you truly value the most. Here's the final lesson. In any enterprise, the real story is always in the people who work there. I sit in lots of meetings, I hear lots of ideas and business reviews. We go through all the details, large and small, but when my teams arrive to brief me and start with the numbers and the financials and the metrics, I always stop and I make them start with the people who are make it all supposed to happen. I want to know who they are, how well they work together, what morale is like. I want to know as much about the caliber of the team and its leaders. I'm never confident until I know that all this is in good order. If their people strategy sound, then I know the numbers will be too. Because the real story is always in the people. It's true on the personal level as well. It makes all the difference, the company you keep every day. I long ago learned to live with and even embrace the certain knowledge that I am very seldom the smartest person in the room, that I can always stand to learn from the people around me and their example. After all, if you're always the smartest person in the room, who's going to keep you sharp? And if you look around and don't see anyone you really admire, who's going to make you want to up your game? Whether you're running a company or starting your first job, the crucial thing is to be around people of ability and character because they're the ones who will make you better. And if I'm any judge, that's how you've spent these years at JMU. And leaving today, finally following those tracks away to points known and unknown, don't doubt for a moment that the good times that came into your life will stay with you, especially these friendships. I remember feeling a little sad on my graduation day, not quite appreciating how even wonderful experiences have to end before new ones can begin. It's true, and that's what all of us wish for all of you. May all that you've found here be just a hint of the achievements, success, and great happiness still to come. Thank you so much, and Godspeed to the class of 2016.
Like I said, that's who you want to become, and many of you will do just that. Before we get into the last half of our ceremony, I want us to give a round of applause to our umbrella bearer who was recruited at the last minute. Thank you.
Thanks.
She has patiently held that umbrella for us, and it's been really important. Graduates whose academic work has been at the highest level deserve special recognition. Students who have achieved a high level of academic excellence are awarded the Latin honors of summa cum laude, magna cum laude, and cum laude. These are designated in your program. Honor students who undertook a program of independent studies and prepared an honors thesis requiring research in his or her academic major are also listed in your program as graduating with distinction. I would like to give all of these graduates the extra acclaim that they deserve, and so I ask any in those categories I just named to please stand and be recognized by our applause. Now, assuming that the rain doesn't get any worse, we're going to proceed with the calling of the names. If we have a torrential downpour start, we're not going to stay out here for that, so we have a backup plan. But we're going to keep our fingers crossed and hope this works. So at this time, I would like to ask, please listen, I would like to ask all of the graduates to please move fairly quickly across the stage so we can get everybody through. I know you want to stop and hug and, you know, greet your faculty, but you can grab them afterwards. And that way I think we may get through almost 800 of you tonight. Okay? So I would now at this time like to ask Dr. Tim Lowers, the director of the School of Accounting, to please come to the podium.
Will the graduates receiving the Bachelor's of Business Administration degree with a major in accounting please rise? Dean Gowan, on behalf of the accounting faculty, I am pleased to present to you the May 2016 James Madison University graduates who have successfully completed the requirements for the Bachelor of Business Administration degree with a major in accounting. Dr. Brad Roof and Professor Ted Browning will represent the accounting faculty in offering congratulations on stage.
Stephanie Gross, Carly Johnston, Thomas Minton V, Michael Brown, Ashley Jasinski, Erica Stadelli, Ashley Morrow, James Maresco, Matthew Prasun, Lavette Howell, William Patterson, Jason Ripley, Anthony Mano, Charles Archer, Ryan Galuli, Andrew Polito, Zachary Zalkowski, Eric Eck, Matthew Bailey, Jeffrey Clay Jr., Michael Quevedo Jr., Sean Dennehy, Michael Garino, James Carbia, Anna Lindstrom, Georgine Willard, Eric Gentile, Corey Witt, Austin Clark, Scott Halpern, Matthew Mintz, Ashley Grasso, Megan Van Kirk, Megan Greed, Kai Lee, Monica McAndrews, Jennifer Feerick, Patrick Ryan, Kyle Prestai, Erica Tatro, Amanda Rowe, Jody Lewis, Marissa Von Conowerf, Gabriella Canistow, Shelly Johnson, Alyssa Ann Ciano, Victoria DiMatteo, Allison Wendell, Maureen DiVelvis, Saru Lay, Yuting Zhu, Callum Kelton, Jacob Cummins, Dylan Knight, Yohoko Aguilar, Zachary Phillips, Christopher Kunza,
John Magnuson,
Connor McLean, Riley William Green, Marcus Bailey, Jessica Medaglia, Madeline Warner, Paige Marple, Robert Valva, Matthew Gordon, William Tyler Davidson, Kathleen Wells, Angela DiMattina, Kelly Greason, Sean McDeed, Spencer Sparrow, Sarah Lanya,
Chris Choi,
Casey Budnick.
Haley Hyman.
Caroline Graff.
Lanny.
Catherine Lanny. Erica Blair. Cameron Baker. Daniel Greenwood. Colin Moody. Daniel Mehring. Justin Ruffalo. Christian Prince. Shannon McGurk. Brian Workman. Shannon Borowski. Lee Doyle. Rebecca Britzenhoff. Emily Del Rosso. Daniel Boulos. Veronica Norris. Haley Lauer. Amber Kennedy. Caitlin Poole. Taehoon Choi. Christopher Campbell. Daniel Vernon. James Hicks. John Karasinski. Ryan Beckett. Cooper Lane. Haley McDermott. Matthew Sweeney. Brittany Boyer. Zachary Carter. Casey Adams. Hunter Evanoff. Quinn Bergeron.
Cho.
Jason Cho. Samuel Huntington. James Ueli. Matthew Hoover.
Will the graduates receiving the Bachelor of Business Administration degree with a major in Computer Information Systems please rise? Dean Gowan, on behalf of the Computer Information Systems and Business Analytics faculty, I'm pleased to present to you the May 2016 James Madison University graduates who has successfully completed the requirements for the Bachelor of Business Administration degree with a major in computer information systems. Professors Jim Jewett and Tony Radcliffe will represent the Computer Information Systems and Business Analytics faculty in offering congratulations on stage.
Olivia Matthews, Joshua Spears, Jessica Valentic, Brian Reinecker, Stephen Hildner Jr., Christopher Nolan, Kevin Watkins, Grant Wise, Hassam Kiff, Christopher Hansen, Daniel Coleman, Matthew McCready, Matthew Schneiderman, Matthew Thompson, Robert Macy, Mo Abu-Anim, Stephen Rhodes, Joseph Bradford, Vivek Narang, Hin Tatvi, Samuel Kubi, Dana Jackson, Shirali Shah, Nicholas Pasalo, Michael Vespa, Sean McMinn, Justin Little, Taylor Wirth, Amy Jekovich, Matthew Valdez, Kyle Walker, Andrew Ramadan, Thomas Wood, Anthony Jewett, Joshua Werner, Scott Filipkowski, Minmin Chang, Samir Desai, Marissa McGill, Christopher Crampton, Emily Kiskaden, Kayrie Bonilla, Melanie Waldron, Taylor Keston Diak, Alex Dixon, Brian Chambers, Michael Jacob, Joshua Gordon, Joseph Clark, Herson Matta, Rebecca Blake, Quinn Nguyen, Nan Ta, Tyler Mamrot, Hannah Blumrick, Christopher Taddy, Benjamin Whitney, Christopher McDaniel, Valerie Pardon, Michael Gerlach, Andrew Gall, Nicholas Snyder, Kevin Smith, Teresa Fink, Megan Ireland, Abdul Khan,
yeah, Abdul.
Ragini Kamani, Ryan Harold, Simon Chim, Brianne Atkins, Darby Roach, Stephanie Palillo, Catherine Wade, Narman Al-Shabani, Alexander Chamblin, Shivraj Narayan, Seth Perkinson, Romana Calachetti, Russell Levine, Paris Gupta, Adam Friedman, Kevin Love. Christopher Robick. Edward Feeney. Patrick Ford. Shelby Spangler. Mazul Islam. Hizang. Shishu Liu. Daniel Day. Matthew Zimmerman. Zachary Archibald. Gregory Fox. Lindsay Bass. Tori Zender. Hayden Hall.
Top 484 is coming.
Daniel Roppert. Alexander Litzima. Alejandro Quesada Pays. Sienna Ventrell. Laura Dobbs. Ryan Lee. Arian Shabazi. Catherine Hun. Brian Hall. Asin Jacques. Hector Santos. Salwa Tuzahi. Haley Cummins. Christopher Fraser. Emmanuel Suarez. Greg Sheneman. Joseph Mastrangelo. Andrew Adams. Ian Brinkerhoff. Zarin Balizi. Peter Tranta. Perry Fabi Jr. Sang Jun Kim. Hui Sung Jong. Joseph Chung. Brian Kim.
Will the graduates receiving the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, or Bachelor of Business Administration degrees with a major in economics please rise? Dr. Gowan, on behalf of the economics faculty, I am pleased to present to you the May 2016 James Madison University graduates who have successfully completed the requirements for the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, or Bachelor of Business Administration degree with a major in economics. Dr. Angela Smith and Dr. Bob Jerome will represent the economics faculty in offering congratulations on stage.
Richard Michael Hunter, Jr. Rachel Hollenbeck. Kendra Christensen.
Natuno.
Laurel Natuno. Rachel Youssef. Christian Embry. Jacqueline Bowles. Brandy Constantino. John Nugent. Abin Dahal. Carter Lane. Tate. Taven Robinson. Ethan Walensky. Berserker Sugbatar. Silu Lee.
Luis Ballesteros.
Georgina Shahan. Megan Mills. Nicole Karsh. Amrit Kaur. Michael Gard. Daniel Gentini Jr. Adam Crum. Alex Sullivan. Sammy Alkatib. Alan Yablonsky Jr. Daniel Foley. Jordan Wilson. Megan Dashner. Jonathan Mraz. Anton Conjavoda. Curtis Hart. Joshua Langhorn. Shelby Rombach.
Mozingo.
Caitlin Mozingo. Hunter White. Alicia Howe. Elijah Howe.
Cyrus Volkshore.
Cyrus Volkshore. Keith Pendergrast. Michael Smith. Eric Carlson. Lara Suraf. Elizabeth Van Toll. Hannah Sampson. Michael Schmidt. Michael McCullough.
Rocha.
Bernardo Rocha.
Eckstein.
Adam Eckstein.
Brown.
Michael Brown.
Casey Hart.
Casey Hart. Martin Benitez Jr. Byron Sullivan. David DeSilvestro. Kurt Everts. Daniel Bianculli.
Seriani.
Ryan Seriani. Christopher Cox. Patrick Tours.
Luthke.
Benjamin Luthke. Garrett Hodgson.
Will the graduates receiving the Bachelor of Business Administration degree with a major in Finance please rise? Dean Gowen, on behalf of Finance and Business Law Faculty, I'm pleased to present to you the May 2016 James Madison University graduates who have successfully completed the requirements for the Bachelor of Business Administration degree with a major in Finance. Dr. Eliza Mann and Dr. Carl Ulrich will represent the Finance and Business Law faculty in offering congratulations on stage.
I'd offer you my code, but it's sopping wet.
Eric Getman, Ryan Kelly, Kyle O'Loughlin, George Gregory III, Sophie Prince, Alexandria Moore, Taylor Lewis, Grant Decker, Alexander Spittle, Dennis Sullivan IV. Evan Fisher. Zachary Murr. Stephen Miller. Meredith Young. Tyler Rafferty. Nicholas Stopek.
Gavin
Terpolowski. Evan Beach. Krista Jenkins. Danielle Meyer. Evan Maroney. Matthew McAdam. Gregory Kumpke.
Aria
Sawant.
Doug
Tam Nguyen. Nimrata Kocher. Chad McGurr. Jasmine Sky Love Grindle. Kyle Petrella. Patrick Schamberger. Brian Sowers. Jonathan Shia. Jalen Doman. Brian Noonan. Scott Weinstein. Kevin O'Connor. Zachary Jacobs. Stephen Chang. Scott Maggot. John Tichonchuk. Sean Mufti. Jacob Pompeo. Frank Imhail. David Tessier. William Strauss. Taylor Gray. Aidan Flattery. Nabil Atassi. Cameron Saidi. Robert Bruno. Martin Sujonis. Emily Blair. Philip Choi. Michael Morningstar Jr.
Brad Buckner.
Michael Brancato. Kelsey Craig. Ian Kinner. William Parker. Taylor Foley. Joseph Marinelli. John Brooks IV. Andrew Sargent. Daniel Speed. Jake Kirby. Francis Kroll. Christian Egan. Keith Kavanaugh Jr. Brian Day. Donna Moberg. Kathleen Fogg. Alexander Holler. Henry Butts. Stephen Amstus. Connor Ryan. Amanda Cameron. Gabriella Cagina. Julian Pina. Gregory Hobson. Andrea Bonner. Brendan Bonner. Patrick Dunbar.
Russ.
Andrew Rossello. Michael Attell. Lindsay Bowles. Scuba Wearup. Jeffrey Choi. Christopher Alderton. Morgan Lawman. James Malgieri. Joseph Evans. Danny Burkhart. Chip Barrazzato. William Stevens. Justin Cannon. Grant Fromke. Alexander Wilkinson. Keegan Alaharian. William Amaker. Alexander Sharon. Kyle Papke.
Sean
Letowski. David Skipper.
Mark Spencer Corkery.
Thank
you.
Samuel Carlin. Patrick Shadel. Patrick Deenan.
There you go.
Joseph Robinson Jr. William Mullery. Jonathan Pomerantz. Carly Holland. Hannah Bullard. Adam Hissong. Lizanne De Lima. Adrian Levat. Joanne Ball. Thomas O'Sullivan. Joseph Burns. Joseph Gracia. Timothy Redshaw.
Loud and proud, loud and proud.
Michael Diffley. Akum Ahmedi. Daniel Golden. Samuel Silek II. Thomas Malley. Sheila Porter. Henry Brandmark. Daniel Cochran. George Snyder. Micah Andrews. Stephen Garrell. Kevin Keselowski.
Graduates receiving the Bachelor of Science degree with a major in Quantitative Finance, please rise. Dean Gowan, on behalf of Finance and Business Law Faculty, I'm pleased to present to you the May 2016 James Madison University graduates who have successfully completed the requirements for Bachelor of Science degree with a major in Quantitative Finance. Dr. Jason Fink and Dr. Pam Drake will represent the Finance and B-Law faculty in offering congratulations on stage.
Derek Pierce, Matthew Calgano, Robert Armitage, Jesse Mark, William Ford, Kittykun Kidge Bomarlar, James Ogden,
can you say my name?
Weesuk Jung, Tyler Amano, John Betts Jr., Andrew Carpenter, Sung Ho Kim.
Graduates receiving the Bachelor in Business Administration degree with a major in International Business, please rise. Dean Gowan, on behalf of the International Business faculty, I am pleased to present to you the May 2016 James Madison University graduates who have successfully completed the requirements for the Bachelor of Business Administration degree with a major in International Business. Dr. Bud Clark and Dr. Naveen Kavashulu will represent the International Business faculty in offering congratulations on stage.
Thank you.
Taylor Raymond. William Griffin. Elena Spriggs. Mariana Manoar. Jesse Gabris. Alejandro Silva. Jonathan O'Connor. Caitlin Irwin. Patrick O'Keefe. Rebecca Quay. Catherine Schindler. Zachary Smith. Kyle Hare. Fran Dresga.
Sawyer Ballard, it might be hard to read.
Sawyer Ballard.
Christopher Mao.
Christopher Mao.
Last name is Cedeno.
Jonathan Cedeno. Santiago Lopera. Andres Jimenez. Tucker Howard.
Brennessel.
Matthew Brennessel. Dalton Harlow. Michael McCluskey. Valerie Smith.
Dejanish.
Gabrielle Dejanish. Annalie Eubanks. Madison Spouts. Amy Edler. Gina Bavagnoli. Alyssa Fayad. Melissa Abood. Alexander Anthony.
Haoji Huang.
Haoji Huang.
Yeah.
Matthias Wust.
This is Dibel.
Dylan Dibel.
Will the graduates receiving the Bachelor of Business Administration degree with a major in management please rise? Dean Gowan, on behalf of the management faculty, I am pleased to present to you the May 2016 James Madison University graduates who have successfully completed the requirements for the Bachelor of Business Administration degree with a major in management. Dr. Ali Shahzad and Professor Chris Roeder will represent the management faculty in offering congratulations on stage.
Good luck.
Lexo Pakadze.
Lexo Pacazza, Adam Drozdak, Luke Bennis, Dalton Malaby, Joseph Thatcher III, Aaron Garber, Lindsay Fox, Artur Schaller, Rushton McCormick, Ryan Becker, Yuqing Zhang, Xiaoming Tao, Ziping Yu, Chuan Sun, Kenneth Ivy Jr., Jillian Keith, Blanca Castro, Fortuna Nui, Alec Moss, Eric Seitz, Casey Ryan, Curtis Dahmer, Jacob Hurd, Caitlin Ely, Allison Gibson, Lauren McParland, Genevieve Bestersey, Jacob Conley, Julia Kahn, Kelly Bewley, Daniel Yurkovic, Jared Spiegel, Corey Dwyer, Stephanie Gamble, Kendra Miller, Sophia Franzek, Michael Stump, Mark Hannibal, Sean O'Rourke, Griffin Lang, Taylor Jones, Colin Johnson, Benjamin Gomez, Matthew Bloom, Anthony Loga, Mitchell Weissman, Eric Fruzano, Joseph Brown, Ryan Wyeth, John Wilk, Michael Line Jr., Colin Clark, Richard Arellano, Christopher Orneman, John Mueller Jr., Lucas O'Connell, Ashlyn Nisker, Rebecca Mann, Taylor Peretti, Layden Nickboxian, Alexandra Petzold, Molly Taylor, Jordan Jazorski, Dalton Doris,
Dashner,
Jefferson Dashner,
James McLeod Rich,
Nicole Philbin, Mackenzie Shields, Alan Jeffers, Timothy Mulligan, Greg Frateroli, Chadwick Hard, Connor Brown, Marshall Pastor, Justin Mills, Lauren McCabe, Abigail Fallon, Nicole Simmons, Richard Mancari, Ashley O'Neill, Earl Johnson, Emmanuel Cousy, Rashad Byers,
no middle name,
Dominic Calandra, Seth Kaltrider, Patrick Kuvalin, Shane Sutton, Samuel Spicer, Simon Hofberger,
Will the graduates receiving the Bachelor's of Business Administration degree with a major in marketing please rise? Dean Gowan, on behalf of the marketing faculty, I am pleased to present to you the May 2016 James Madison University graduates who have successfully completed the requirements for a Bachelor's of Business Administration degree with a major in marketing. Dr. Mert Tokman and Dr. Jana Parker will represent the marketing faculty in offering congratulations on stage.
Max Truchin, Alexander McElwee, Leora Kahn, Amy Goff, Rachel Brody, Alexandra Ender, Sarah Quinn,
Kevin Simpson, Andy Rockelli, Myanne Fan,
Christine
Vanderhooten, Brendan Maya, Kevin Taggart, Job Mengistu, Corinne Cardinal, Aaron Matthews, Madison Biernacki, Emma Schmidtline, Jonathan Daly, Zachary Claridge, Philip Hallett, Stephen Kirst, Corey Brashears, Marissa Regee, Mitchell Wilt, Kyle Berry, Milo Rubin, Charles Bartlett, Alexander Murphy, Nicole Asaban, Jonathan Robbins, Joseph Straub, Colin Rao, Jordan Ember, Taylor Glazebrook, Sarah Daniel, Tyler Faley, Carrie-Anne Grandaza, Brenna Dolan, Carly Harrison, Paige Moore, Renee Anton, Ashlyn Manley,
Carrie
Ross,
Yen
Rin, Allison DeNoble, Samantha Blaylock, Matthew O'Reilly, Christine Provino, Julie Dew, Emily Maynard, Drew Dyer,
Beveridge,
Catherine Beveridge, Ann Uvain, Elizabeth Butler, Elizabeth Norcott, Reagan Haley, Katie Vink, Caitlin Toe, Jacob Acosta, Bradley Drew, Matthew Crobath, Mark Gunst, Alexander Glom, Michael O'Day, Aaron Dooley, Bridget Reardon, Caitlin Fuchs, Sarah Jones, Kayla Gibbs, Megan Ryan, Lauren Garufi, Charlotte Parkhurst, Christopher Talbot, Kenneth Gladding, Christopher Elefante, Jenna Mertz, Megan Niski, Lauren Budzinski, Alicia Roller, Rose Somavigo, Tyler Senna, Kevin Gambrell, Brooks Chilcoat, Andrew Carlin, Rachel Dancy, Allison Tugentman,
real enthusiasm,
Max Block,
Nizavaccia,
Joseph Nizavaccia, Melissa Bianco, Kaylee Harrison, Laura Hart,
Benjamin Laser Saffron.
Benjamin Laser Saffron. Jacob Shibley.
Sitos.
Andrew Sitos.
Jacob Brown. Trevor Wilder.
Tom
Fooey. Matthew Brookman. Ryan Talento. Alexander Adley. Tyler Smith. Akash Patak. Coleman Fleming. Sydney DeBowie. Natalie Cruin. Ann Delafield. Derek Smith. Caitlin Fakak. Matthew Dieters. Claudia Schnorbus. Catherine Smoral. Brianna Walker. Taylor Lasinski. Neil Vespa. John Thompson.
Carly
Knutsius. Carly Knutsius. Evan Gibbon. Brianna Barton. Colleen McLaughlin.
Yeah, call.
Molly McDevitt. Mary Redman. Francesca Ferrone. Shannon Goodwin. Morgan Foran.
Heather
Lewing. Allison Morabito. Matthew Narzikal. Gregory Kozlowski.
You guys are awesome. All right. With the graduates receiving the first ever Bachelor of Science degree in the Hart School with a major of Hospitality Management, please rise. Dean Gowan, on behalf of the Hart School faculty, I am pleased to present to you the May 2016 James Madison University graduates who have successfully completed the requirements for the Bachelor of Science degree with a major in hospitality management. Professors Teresa Lind and Miguel Baltazar will represent the hospitality management faculty and offering congratulations on stage.
Nera Mamagani. Catherine Horlocker. Madison Trumbull. Devin Darnell. Natalie Coppola. Catherine Deneen. Laura Chilton. Nicole Pelletier. Hannah Lawson. Audra Avery. Hans Kunz. Jennifer Oliver. Marisa Ramsey, Brittany Schott, Rebecca Kuhn,
Unique
Hamilton, Jennifer Nguyen, Catherine Call, Allison Sved, Lauren Rhodes, Peter McAteer III, Hannah Lear, Megan Gilliam,
Tim Hussa,
Eisenhower.
Jessica Eisenhower, Molly Kaplan, Susan Thorpe, Holly Davis. Cindy Cho. Blanca Alvarez Martinez. Tara Melke. Logan Reed. Grace O. Rachel Baruti. Olivia Helsey. Joseph Horton. Sean Shrampko. Matt Southall. Lindsay DiRienzo. Julie Challenger. Linda Song. Emmanuel Kahn. Jack Martin.
Jack Martin.
James DeCourt. Erica Bloom. Alexa Cachetta. Katie Lashinsky. Catherine Haskins. Schaefer Beardsley. Ira Beatty. Kayla Da Silva. Tasha Kaisanmore. Elizabeth Gilbride. Jillian Goodrich. Luis Lopez. Hamza Alam. Justin Clark. Michael Bedford. Joshua Marshall. Arlington Kelly. Kristen Gunthorpe. Caitlin Johnston. Elizabeth Tooney. Anna Grove. Daniela Ilijic. Natalie Van Fleet. Kelsey Nealon. Emily Carrara. Erica Zimbelman. Brianna Keefe. Catherine Nichols. Morgan Hurley. Sarah Ives. Danielle Taylor. Kirsten Bianco. Meredith Campbell. April C. Hannah O'Shea. Catherine Willis. Hannah Wilson. Robin Falchi. Alexander Ostupovich. Ashley McMillan. Rachel Dorian. Annie Schmidt. Tyler Beiswanger. Alex Seitz. Joseph Nardulolo. Daniel Costello.
Eileen
O'Hearn.
Corinne
Buriel. Alexis Fry. Alexander Mochiber. Sheldon Gagne. Ivy Perkins. Alicia Wimmer. Carrie Young. Kristen Allen. Lauren Beasley. Abigail Cottrell.
All right, well, the graduates receiving the first ever Bachelor of Science degree with a major in Sport and Recreation Management, please rise. Dean Gowan, on behalf of the Hart School faculty, I am pleased to present to you the May 2016 James Madison University graduates who have successfully completed the requirements for the Bachelor of Science degree with a major in Sport and Recreation Management. Professor Neil Marin and Dr. Mickey Sato will represent the Sports and Recreation Management faculty and offering congratulations on stage.
Justin Sehalot. Matthew Taylor. Max Redding. Thomas Grant IV. Jordan Cleavy. Jacob Swan. Alora Henry. McKenna Kendrick. Helen Kendall. Sean Sniffen. Lindsay Kaler, Jameer Bumbry, Samantha O'Brien, Joseph Massissa, Eric Schmidt, Alyssa Zerlo, Carly Jenkins, Mitchell Pitts, the Duke Dog, Precious Hall, Jesse Carmen, Chandler Knight, Tevin Herndon,
thank you, sir.
Yang Yang, Andrew Brownlee, Christopher Haynes, Caitlin Sundheim, Michael Orvis, Matthew Ferrer, Kevin Schaefer, Madison McMillan, Amanda Malik, Eleanor Kent, Ryan Bever, Alec Coughlin, David Halstead, Andre Lohman, Anna Hogue, Simon Short, Kevin Smick, Charles Zeman, Morgan Meskin, Natalie Fioretto, Blake Shields, Ellery Price, Tracy Stoidel, Anthony Brown, Corey Fritz, Stavance Boiser, Jessica Carney, Jesse Moses, Michael Karen, William King, Maxwell Swartz, Kyle Setterland, Kyle Weston, Taylor Krug,
yes, you did it right.
Kevin Hussam, Casey Oberhammer, Aaron Orison, Jesse Hoover,
Kirkendall.
Joseph Kirkendall, Brooke Scheiman, Evelyn Brown, Connor Donnelly, Lauren Kane, Kevin O'Malley, John Dickerson, Kyle Rigney, William Stewart, Carly Alexander, Gage Steele, Alexander Vella, Douglas Dragon, Tyler Murphy, Travis Euler, Yeshin Kim, Michael Ockamp Jr., Anthony Miscavige, Caleb Wallace, Alexa Cohen, Ron Curry,
don't trip on
2016, the faculty of the College of Business has prepared you well for what is before you. Now it's your responsibility to go out into the world and truly make the difference. Make us proud.
Wait a minute. The alma mater, which was written by the late JMU faculty member Dr. James R. Riley, will be led by Kyle Yampiro. Please rise for the alma mater and remain standing.
Madison, James Madison, will be forever true. Our loyalty will always be to JMU, while friends remain within our hearts and knowledge guides our way. James Madison will lead us on to conquer each new day. Thank you.